sunny coast girl, local girl, our Lynette Noni is carving up quite an impressive career for herself.
Currently, Australia's number one young adult fiction writer, which means it's for folks a little bit, just a touch younger than you and I.
Well known also. Well known for the Medoran Chronicles series as well, which she, you know, got most of her notoriety, and this is really impressive.
I have to say, there was much great excitement in my house when I put this out, because across the top, authors, of course, always recommend each other's books.
They do.
And it says, wonderful recommendation from Sarah J. Maas, who is one of the biggest YA, well, actually probably the biggest, most well-known YA author in the world.
And huge book reviewed before?
Throne of Glass.
We love that book,
we love Throne of Glass.
Yes.
So that set off a chain reaction in my house, because my 15-year-old son loved that and everything else of Sarah J. Maas's. So when I read this, I thought, oh, hang on a minute. He'll love this. And then not only does she recommend on the front, when you actually go inside the book, lovely Lynette has actually dedicated the book to Sarah J. Maas for being such a great friend and great support, and they're currently collaborating on a project.
Oh,
so I was like, ching, ching, ching.
Exciting.
It ticked every box. So I handed it straight to my son and said, I think you might like this. And he was pretty happy. He's partway through it. And yeah,
so
really
you're
enjoying
saying
it.
So you give your kids your book to review?
Sometimes. Well, I want his opinion because he's 15 and I'm not 15.
True. It's his genre, isn't it? It's his age bracket, not
absolutely.
Your age bracket. Probably more so mine.
Yeah, absolutely. And like a lot of these kind of fantasy novels, it does start with a fantastic little map of where we are.
I love the maps. Whenever you have a fantasy book, you need a good map.
Do you sit down and work out what's
where? I do. I actually go back. So whenever I re-get into a chapter, I go, ah, that's right. Where's that again? I'll go back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Very important.
It's mostly set in Zalandov prison. Kiva is our main character. As a very young child, she is sent there, the family drama, sent there, and she's the healer in the prison.
I like the fact that she's a healer. Most of our female protagonists are sort of some femme fatale type character.
Well, she
kind of is. Yeah, but she's more of a healer. I like the fact that she's a healer in a prison, which is obviously not the right place.
Yeah, but it's not a nice place, and she has to do lots of not great stuff. And basically, there is someone there who is terminally ill, and Ziva steps in for her because her family has told her she has to save them. So she basically goes in to face all of the great challenges against
the Earth Wind Fire. She puts her hand up, doesn't she?
Mm.
Trial by ordeal is what... That sounds
It sounds like something you did on Survivor. No one ever survives these, so she steps in. It's pretty brutal. Like, she gets pretty beaten up in a lot of these scenes, but she's a great survivor. And there's a little bit of romance along the way, all of the good things that young adults like to read.
There's a plague too, an infestation plague across the city as well. There's obviously a little, you know, some sort of little romance, inmate romance.
Inmate.
And also there's a riot. Who doesn't love a good riot in a prison? You know, and I think the reason why I love this, Vic, is that it took me back to, even though this is fantasy, you know, I love prison movies, and my number one movie of all time, I know this is a book review, but it was The Shawshank Redemption. So it took me back into a space where, into this prison scene, and, you know, escapism and things like that. So, yeah.
All right.
Yeah, there you go.
I don't know, Kiva, Morgan Freeman. Yeah, kind of just the same.
The
I love this girl.
This
I kept thinking,
though.
When I read this, I kept thinking, I wonder who would play Kiva, because she's a really tough, strong character, beautiful teen girl. I don't know, I was rattling through all the, you know, all the big ones. But, yeah, it's a good read. I think for this genre and this, people that like Sarah J. Maas, as the book says, will enjoy this one. It is different to her other series, but and I'm looking very much forward to seeing what the collaboration with Sarah J. Maas is going to be. But I think this is a good one. My son is enjoying it, so that's a thumbs up from me anytime. So for me, it's a 3.5, but I think if you're of the right age, a touch younger than you and I, I'm going to say 4.5.
Because I'm young and because I'm in that sort of space where I get this content, you probably don't because you're a little bit older.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it a 4 because it really related to me.
Look at that. Lee has to go. What I quite like about Lynette Noni's books is that the characters you can actually spell and say their names. Because, you know, quite often in these fantasy novels, they're so out there that as you're reading, you have to keep stopping to think how to pronounce the name, because I can't just read and brush over a name, I've got to pronounce it.
So, I often do the opposite. I pronounce it and then find out later that I've pronounced it absolutely incorrect. But I noticed that all fantasy books, you need a lot of V's, Z's and X's.
Yeah, Kivas,
you don't have a lot of them in your book.
Nurgles,
it's not a proper fantasy book.